Amateur Radio Association. What is 10 years out of the lifetime of a man? Measured in terms of the humdrum routines of everyday living, 10 years can pass like 10 minutes, uncounted and unremembered. But measured in time, in terms of friends made, of new experiences and services rendered, 10 years can pass like 10 lifetimes, every minute counted and recounted in the storehouse of one's memory. Such a time occurred in a decade of the 1970s. For me and a group of radio amateurs in a golden age of telecommunication. We all started out as a gun club just before martial law, called Rainbow Communications. All members being enthusiasts of the amateur 2-meter band installed in our cars. We all had pseudonyms. I was Aries, because that is my from the Greek. And Jose Maria Gonzalez, who will be here, was Bouncer, because he was quick with his fists. The Rainbow Club was our club, and it offered to be and was recruited as the mobile cars of the Metro Manila Police Department, with us providing the transceivers and the armed backup, because we were better than the policemen when it came to target shooting. We participated in police raids and riot control. At the outset of martial law, our guns were confiscated by the government. So we concentrated on ham radio under auspices of the Philippine Amateur Radio Association, of which Jose Maria Gonzalez served as president and I as executive vice president and editor of our official QTC magazine. We answered emergencies, including escorting pregnant women to the hospital during the curfew hours of the martial law. And we braved the typhoons to provide communication in the farthest reaches of the nation. In many cases, in many times, the army communication system did not work. Only the radio amateurs were the only communication possible during the storms. That happened also even in Yolanda. We were able to communicate radio hams in the Soviet Union and Eastern Europe for the first time. We talked to Senator Barry Goldwater, ex-Prime Minister of Malaysia, Tunku Abdul Rahman, and the King of Jordan. One Filipino doctor, Eduardo Garcia, DU6EG, even directed an appendectomy operation in a tramp steamer bound for Singapore. We rescued a ship stranded in the Carolines. We passed American soldiers during the Tet Offensive in Vietnam by telephone to their beloved ones in the United States. We got students from Don Bosco to teach us the Morse code. There was only one terrible thing that happened to us. We had two trusted secretaries who betrayed us. For years, they pocketed the money for postage and threw our QSL cards into the basura that was intended for mailing into the basura. And one of them is even the niece of the NTC commissioner at the time. Because of Jose Mari, the superstar of the Late Late Show, and my son Ronnie and Ares, we were able to have as guests many celebrities such as Vilma Santos, who happened to be the girlfriend of my son at the time, Sharon Cuneta, Butch Anson-Roa, Elizabeth Oropesa, Lorna Tolentino, and Daria Ramirez. We had a wonderful gang. Many of them already passed away. Among them, Golden Heart, Jose Tupas, D-U-1-J-J-T, our close friend Charlie Mike, Cesar Maloles, D-U-1-C-M, and Earl Hornbostel, D-U-1-A-E, an American veteran who was a citizen of the Philippines, was one of the very first ham radio operators in the Philippines. President Jose Mari Gonzalez, who we honored in 1977, does. The most interesting of all is our present president, Jose Mari Gonzalez, whom we honored in 1977. To Jose Mari Bouncer Gonzalez, D1JMG, movie hero off and on the silver screen, highway buff, outdoorsman, scuba diver, DXer rally driver, businessman, bomba exhibitionist, great lover, spoiled brat, and egomaniac, who for many years generously donated his time, talents, and resources to PARA in exchange for one continuous gigantic ego trip as the leading man in a true-to-life motion picture. Taking the role of a prince, giving largesse to the multitudes, he lavished cash, the use of his magnificent equipment, and the performances of his movie star friends on many PARA projects. He shows off the best amateur radio gear, the best hi-fi system, the best looking wife. And like the movie hero that he is, he goes to the limit to prove that he can drink the greatest amount of beer, collect the most amount of QSL cards, drive the fastest, dive the deepest, climb the highest, conquer the strongest man, and make love to the most beautiful women. He is used to winning, and if defeat comes once in a while, as it comes to all mortals, he gets into a terrible tantrum and threatening to resign from the PARA, until it was pointed out to him that the only way he can resign a lifetime membership is by committing suicide. For bringing Technicolor, CinemaScope, and stereophonic sound into our prosaic lives, Jose Mari Gonzalez, alias Diablo, alias Bouncer, deserves a plaque in lieu of an Oscar. This is a speech I made in November 23, year 2002, a few years ago. I repeat it now for the young and vibrant members of our new PARA, with its 3,000 members. Thank you very much.